ஸ்ரீ சச்சிதானந்த சத்குரு சாயிநாத் மகராஜ் கீ ஜெய். ஸ்ரீ சாய் சச்சரித்ரா அண்ட் இன்சைட் எபிசோட் 155. மை ஹம்பிள் ப்ரொஸ்ட்ரேஷன்ஸ் அட் த லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட் ஆஃப் அவர் சத்குரு சாய். பை த டிவைன் கிரேஸ் ஆஃப் சாய் அன் அட்டெம்ப்ட் ஹேஸ் பீன் மேட் டு ட்ரான்ஸ்லேட் த ஜிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த டிவைன் டிஸ்கோர்ஸ் of Sri Ramanathan brother telecasted in Sai TV. This is purely done to share the glory of Sai and his divine teachings with more insight to the aspirants. Om Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnuhu Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Parabrahmam தஸ்மை ஸ்ரீ குரவே நமஹா. டெவோட்டீஸ், லெட் அஸ் கண்டினியூ டு ஹீட் டு த அமேசிங் லீலாஸ் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீ சாய் மகாராஜ் ரிலேட்டட் டு ஸ்ரீ லக்ஷ்மி பாய் கப்பர்டே. லக்ஷ்மி பாய் கப்பர்டே டியூரிங் ஹர் ஸ்டே இன் ஷிரடி, தட் இஸ் ஃபார் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் அ பீரியட் ஆஃப் 7 months, வுட் எவ்ரி டே ப்ரிப்பேர் பிரசாதம் ஃபார் ஸ்ரீ சாய் இன் ஹர் ஓன் ஹேண்ட்ஸ், take it and offer it to Sri Sai Baba, and would partake it only after that was accepted by the Supreme God, Sri Sai Baba. Sri Sai Maharaj had decided to exhibit her prema bhakti to others, hence he portrayed a divine leela which is very interesting. Devotees, this is not new. The Supreme Lord always plays his divine sport to display the loving devotion of his ardent devotee to others. On March 4, 1912, as usual, she prepared the food with so much love and care and brought the same to Dwaraka Mai to offer it to Sri Sai Baba. That day, the platter contained many delicious varieties of dishes: sansa, bat, varan, kheer, shira puri, sandge, papad, koshmibiri. By the time she brought all these palatable dishes, it got little late than the usual lunchtime of Sri Sai. Because every noon it was customary to keep all the dishes offered by the devotees for Sri Sai in front of the nimbar, and then Sri Sai Maharaj would place the food into the kolamba, mix it with his own hands, then distribute to the devotees. A screen will be drawn and few ardent devotees would sit in two rows on either side of Sri Sai Maharaj and he would sit in the middle. Then the consecrated food will be served to all the devotees. Later, the same will be partaken by Sri Sai Maharaj, while other devotees would be seated in the Sabha Mandap outside the Sanctum Sanctorum. That day, it was time for consecrating the food and partaking the prasadam. Though it was past time, Sri Sai Maharaj didn't get up from his seat to consecrate the food, so everyone was puzzled at this delay. Just then, Sri Lakshmi Bai Kapparde reached Dwaraka Mai swiftly, holding a platter full of delicious dishes. As soon as Sri Sai noticed her, immediately got up from the seat and called out to the devotees to come to have prasadam. He wanted everyone to understand that he had been waiting for this food, as this is a part of his divine sport. As soon as she got the food, Sri Sai received it, stretching both his hands and said, "Oh mother, have you brought it? Come, give the food to me." Sri Sai was dramatizing this play brilliantly. To everyone's surprise, he did not keep up with the tradition as said before. Instead, he took the plate, removed the cover and gulped morsel after morsel. Devotees watched at this in wonder. Shama, who was seated there, too gazed at this in amazement and immediately asked, "Deva, what is this? Your behavior is very strange to us. Why should there be such a distinction? Why should such a worldly attitude affect a saint? There is some tactic of yours here. Many other Naivedyas came. They are even far superior to this, but they remain untouched. Why should you have such likes and dislikes? You keep aside all other platters, even if some are made of silver, you hurl them far away. But as soon as this lady's platter came, you pulled up your sleeves to receive and relish it. This is really surprising. What is the reason behind all this? Now Sri Sai Maharaj spoke thus, Shama, what can I say about the superiority of this food? It is very special to me because saying so. Sri Sai began to list out the connection he had with the previous births of Sri Lakshmi Kapardi. In her earlier birth, she was a very fat cow of a merchant, yielding large quantity of milk, which made me very happy. This means that Sri Sai had consumed the milk provided by that cow. Then Sri Sai continued, she was born in a gardener's family. Later she was reborn in a Kshatriya family and got married to a merchant. Now she took birth in a Brahmin family. I saw her after a very long time. Hence, let me take few morsels of her food that she offers with love. So devotees, the explanation or justification that Sri Sai Maharaj gives about his behavior to Shama clearly explicates that he always earns for loving devotion and now he is pleased by that prema bhakti of Lakshmi Kapardi and has been accepting it from her births after birth. The details of her previous birth given by Sri Sai also reveals the evolution of her soul. The first stage or birth of her was the cow, which is an animal. Then she was born in a farmer's family, that is to a person who was involved in service, then as a Kshatriya, that is in a ruler's family and married to a Vaishya, then now born in a Brahmin family and her food I need to relish without any disturbance, says Sri Sai Maharaj. Devotees, isn't these details astounding? Who else other than the Supreme Lord can witness the various evolution of a soul and identify it birth after birth? This is another testimony to the fact that Sri Sai Baba is a divine incarnation of the Lord. Sri Sai gulped the food morsel after morsel brought by Sri Lakshmi Kapardi to illustrate to others that he would accept whatever that has been offered with love. We just said that she came little late that noon to offer the food. Though the reason is not mentioned in Sri Sai Satcharitra, let us ponder on this in detail now. On 4th March 1912, she organized a function known as Dole Jeevan. This is like the baby shower celebration done for the to-be moms. Dole Jeevan is a function conducted for the pregnant ladies in the family. The relatives and friends of that lady would cook the favorite dishes of the pregnant woman, drape her with new sari, decorate with flowers, make her wear plenty of glass bangles and do arati. Lakshmi Kapardi is a very sweet and kind-hearted lady. She would do this function to any lady who is pregnant. So, on 4th March, she had gone to perform this function to a pregnant woman. Thus, she was little late to bring her noon prasadam to Sri Sai Maharaj. This information was recorded in Shiradi diary. Devotees, there is another incident connected to this function in Shiradi diary. Lakshmi Kapardi also performed this Dole Jeevan to the wife of their servant Balakrishna Nene in a fabulous way. She would always help the needy and cared for their welfare. Kapardey was very affluent. He was held in high esteem by everyone in the society, and Lakshmi Kapardey was always living a very comfortable life and well respected. Now there is one more incident to quote from the Shiradi diary. There was a boy named Nilkari. He got a big bobu on his thigh, and he belonged to a very poor family. He was hospitalized. He had lost his mother, and there was none to take care of him. Lakshmi Kapardey, though hailed from a wealthy family, would personally take the cooked food and give this boy, who stayed near their home, spread some ointment on his wound and took care of him. She could have been sent the food and medicine through her maid, but she preferred to do it by herself. So, every day Lakshmi Kapardey went to Nilkari and took care of him. She was her love for others. Later, this Nilkari recalled this timely help and care of Lakshmi Kapardey and with heartfelt gratitude said, "If Sri Lakshmi Kapardey had not taken care of me as that of a loving mother, then my survival itself would have been a question mark." These incidents portray the compassion of Sri Lakshmi Kapardey to others. Apart from these great qualities, she was also an expert in providing medicine for jaundice. Kapardey's mother, that is Lakshmi Bai Kapardey's mother-in-law, was proficient in giving herbal medicines for jaundice. Those days, some people were experts in dispensing medicine for jaundice, and the patient, just by taking one dose of it, would get completely cured from the disease. One such person was Kapardey's mother, and this practice has been followed in their family and passed on to generations after generation, thus was taught to the daughter-in-law, that is Lakshmi Kapardey. And Lakshmi Kapardey provided this medicine for free of cost to the patients as a service to the community. From the neighboring villages, every day at least 4 to 5 patients would approach her seeking medicine for jaundice, and it was provided by Lakshmi Kapardey. Thus, many were benefited and recovered from this disease. Such was her empathy for the society. Sri Sai Baba, who is aware of all her great qualities, provided her the timely guidance and uplifted her in the spiritual path. Every guidance of Sri Sai stands out as a miracle. Now let us get back to the original miracle, wherein Sri Sai listed out the details of Lakshmi Kapardey's previous births. Then, after eating the food offered by her, belched out loudly to indicate that his stomach is full and is delighted with the delicious offering. Then got up from there and moved to his asana. Lakshmi Kapardey was awestruck watching these, felt extremely happy that Sri Sai Baba accepted her offering and relished it to his heart's content, which he implied by burping. She now went and prostrated to Sri Sai and sat next to him to perform her service by pressing the divine feet of Sri Sai Maharaj. While she was pressing his feet, the most merciful Sri Sai showered his grace upon this blessed devotee thus. In a very low tone, Sri Sai said, "Mother, always chant Raja Ram, Raja Ram. That will do good for you." This is a very rare phenomenon because we have not come across a leela that expounds Sri Sai Baba's mantra upadesh or initiation to any devotee. But Lakshmi Kapardey was the most blessed one who received it from Sri Sai Baba while he was in his mortal coil. But Sri Sai very competently made this a casual event and not like a formal ritual. Devotees might recall that in Sri Sai Satcharitra, Hemant Panji had mentioned that when Radhabai Deshmukh came to Shiradi and took a vow to fast until she gets initiated by Sri Sai Maharaj, Sri Sai Baba advised her that, "Mother, my guru never blowed any mantra into my ears, so I cannot give you one, and you please meditate upon me, and that will keep you in good stead," and never gave her any mantra to chant. So now, some of you might question, if Sri Sai had not given any mantra to her, strangely, even though Lakshmi Bai Kapardei never asked for any mantra, she had been asked to chant Raja Ram, Raja Ram incessantly. Lakshmi Kapardei would have not even realized that she was initiated by Sri Sai Baba and must have taken as a casual advice by Sri Sai Baba as he cares for her welfare. But the moment these holy words were uttered by Sri Sai, immediately that penetrated her heart and became embedded there. This is one of the ways of initiating a disciple by the Guru and is known as Shaktipat. As Hemat Panji mentions, Sai's methods are inscrutable. In a very subtle way, when none can even contemplate what type of blessing would be showered upon whom, the boon will be granted by Sri Sai Maharaj. This blessing made her spiritual progress very rapid, because the greatest blessing a devotee can get from his guru is the initiation. If the devotee is not competent enough, then such a boon is not granted by the guru. As this is one of the most significant blessings in a person's life, and moreover, such a boon has not been granted by Sri Sai Baba upon any other devotee. This has been described by Pujya Sri Narasimha Swamiji in Sri Sai Sahasranamavali as Om Rama Mantra Upadesha Kaya Namaha. Salutations to the one who taught the Rama Mantra. Listeners might think that Sri Sai Baba's instructions to his devotees are contradicting with each other. To one, he gives a mantra. To the other, he is asking to meditate upon his form. Few are advised to do parayanam of the poti, while others are asked to be quiet and not engage in any reading. But we should keep in mind that instructing based on whatever is suitable for each one is a special attribute of a Sadguru, and the same was followed by Sri Sai Baba. To compare, a pharmacy will have various kinds of medicines. For instance, they might have medication for loose motion and for constipation. Depending on the need of the person, the relevant medicine is prescribed by the doctor. Similarly, a Sadguru is one who chose the best path for each one based on their qualities and grant the one that is beneficial to them. Following this, Sri Sai also granted another blessing to this mother, which is mind-boggling and very clandestine. Sri Sai, to establish faith upon the devotees, even took various forms and blessed them. We shall listen to those interesting leelas in the coming episode. Bow to Sri Sai. Peace be to all. Om Sai Ram.